Good morning, students. This is Joy Varghese from Uncovering Chemistry. Today in video 16 of Chemical Kinetics, we are going to discuss textile numericals 4.27, 4.28, 4.29 and 4.30. Okay, so when we say the first question 4.27, you can see in this what is written here. Okay, what is written? See, the rate constant for the first order decomposition of hydrogen peroxide is given by the following equation. This is the equation what is given. Calculate Ea for this reaction. At what temperature will the half period, means T half, be, what we call it as, 256 minutes. Okay, so this one what we have to calculate. First Ea we will calculate, but for that we need to compare this equation with Arrhenius equation. Okay, so this one we are going to do next. Okay, now in your book T half was given as 256 minutes, what we say. Understood? 256 minutes. But now when we say according to Arrhenius equation, right? According to Arrhenius equation, we know that K is equal to A into e raised to minus Ea by RT. So if you take log on both the side, what it will be? Log K is equal to log A, right? Log K is equal to log A minus Ea by 2.303 RT. Understood? This I will give as equation 1. Now what was given? The given equation in your textbook, that is in the question, the given equation is, what was that? It is given like this, that is log K is equal to 14.34 minus 1.25 into 10 raised to 4 K by T. This was the equation was given. Huh? In your book it is given T inverse it is. So I wrote it down, huh, like this. Now, in this case when we say as K and A are constants. Understood? K and A are constant, what we say here. You can see here. What I will do? This will get cancelled. This log K means if you compare, when we say comparing equation 1 and this one, I will give equation 2. Okay, comparing equation 1 and 2, we get what? Okay, so in this case log k will get cancelled, this is the value of A will get cancelled as these are constant. Then here also you can see this temperature T and T will get cancelled. Understood? So this is the part what we are discussing about. Now T and T will get cancelled. So now what is remaining? So if you compare these two, this one and this one, this all thing get cancelled. We got minus, like this it is, minus Ea upon 2.303 R is equal to minus 1.25 into 10 raised to 4 K, like this. Okay, so what will happen in this case? This minus will become plus. So what is left out? Ea upon 2.303 R is equal to this value. So now what will be Ea, which we say here? Ea will be equal to 1.25 into 10 raised to 4 into 2.303 into R. This R will go here, so which is 1.25 into 10 raised to 4 into 2.303, and R value we know it is 8.314. Joule I am taking and not taking kilojoule. Afterward you will convert it if you want. Okay, so what it will be, if you simplify this, you will get 23.934 into 10 raised to 4 joule mole inverse. So now what I will do, I will shift this decimal on this side here. So it will be 23934 into 10 raised to 3 joule mole inverse. Okay. So 10 raised to 3 means what? Kilo K. Okay. So kilo joule mole inverse, this will be 239. Clear? I have shifted here. 0.34. So this is the value of Ea, that is the first part of the question. Okay, so that we got here. Now, for half life, what was given? For half life, when we say half life period. For half life period, k value we will find out. Half life period for first order reaction. Okay, first order reaction we can write here, that is T half is equal to 0.693 by K. Right? So therefore K will be equal to 0.693 by T half. Okay? Now we were knowing that T half value is given, it is 256 minutes if you remember. Understood? So now this 256 minutes, no, we need to convert it into seconds, what we say. Okay. So here, okay, so this will convert it before only, that is, which is equal to 256 minute into, that is, 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Huh? So like this we will convert it by multiplying it with 60. So you will get here, I'll just directly take this value here only. Huh? So which is equal to, you can see here, 0.693 by 256 into 60. So this second it will be. Why? Because as first order reaction, our unit of first order is second inverse, and that's why we have converted this. Unit of rate constant is second inverse. So if you simplify this, this will become second inverse, up it will go. Huh? And the value of K for this 256 minute will be, it will be 4.51 into 10 raised to minus 5 seconds, like second inverse. Okay. So this is the value of K, what we found out at 256 minutes. Okay. Now the next part. Okay. Here only we'll complete. K value we got. Now the next question is, so that is substituting the value of K in equation 1. Right. Now equation 1 means what I was talking about here, this part of equation 1, you know, I think 2 it will be in equation 2. Okay, now this is your equation 2 which was given, if you see in your textbook what was given in the question. Okay, so in this we will substitute the value of k. So the equation was like this, that is log k is equal to 14.34 minus 1.25 into 10 raised to 4 k by t. Okay, this was the value what was given. So what we will do, I will substitute the value of log k. The log 4.51, that is what we got, k into 10 raised to minus 5 is equal to 14.34 minus this, it is 1.25 or 125, huh? Let me see. Okay, we will do one thing, this 1.25 into 10,000 we will do, so it will be 1250 k by. Understood? Now this value, if you simplify this now for this value of log, that is log 4.51 into means plus minus 5 log 10 to the base 10. Huh? If you don't understand, you can do like this. 4.51 plus minus 5 log 10 to the base 10 means for this multiplication plus sign is there. So log 4.51 minus 5 and log to the base 10 is 1. Okay. So which is equal to 14.34 minus 12500 k by t. Okay. So if you simplify this, you will get the value. This one will be equal to, this will be minus 5. So this one will be minus 4.3458. is equal to 14.34 minus 12500 k by t. Okay, now on the next side we will do. Okay, this is the part where we stop. So what we will do, we'll take this on the either side. So it will be minus 4.3458 minus 14.34 is equal to minus 12500 k by t. Okay, so now here what we will do, this will be minus minus is plus, so it will be minus 18.6858 is equal to minus 12500 k by t. So what we can do, this minus minus will become plus. Okay, multiplying both the side with minus 1. So what is remaining now? This, therefore, I can write T will be equal to 12500K by 18.6858. And if you simplify, T will be equal to 668.95 Kelvin. Clear? Or this T, approximately you can write 669 Kelvin is your answer. Understood? So this is little bit lengthy sum, can be asked for 4 marks. So go through it. Okay, the next one now. Okay, now the next question is 4.28. The decomposition of A into product has the value. A into product means like this, A to product. Clear? The value of K is given here at the temperature is also given, and the energy of activation means Ea value is given, 60 kilojoule mole inverse. At what temperature would K would be? 1.5 into 10 raised to 4 second inverse. Okay, so this at what value, what temperature, same what we did here, little bit here also we have to do. Okay, if you want you can do it as homework, but I will just solve it, you can practice at home later on. Okay, let's see this question. Okay, according to data, if you see, K1 was given as 4.5 into 10 raised to 3 second inverse. Now as this is second inverse, it's a first order reaction. Okay, then T1 was given equal to 10 degrees Celsius, but that we will convert it, clear, to Kelvin, and that will be 283.15 Kelvin. Okay, T1. Then K2 was also given 1.5 into 10 raised to 4 second inverse. R value we can take 8.314 into 10 raised to minus 3 kilojoule mole inverse Kelvin inverse. Okay, same way Ea value is also given, Ea 60 kilojoule mole inverse. Okay, and T2 you have to find. Understood? So now according to this, as it is first order, so according to our Arrhenius equation, if you remember, according to Arrhenius equation, clear, Arrhenius equation, we know what is the formula, that is log K2 upon K1 is equal to Ea upon 2.303 R into 1 upon T1 minus 1 upon T2. Okay, so we will substitute all this value, that is log 1.5 K2 is into 10 raised to 4 second inverse upon 4.5 into 10 raised to 3 second inverse is equal to Ea is 60 kilojoule whole upon 2.303 into 8.314 into 10 raised to minus, sorry, 10 raised to minus 3 kilojoule mole inverse Kelvin inverse, okay, into temperature, that is 1 upon 283.15, that is T1, into 1 upon T2, like this. Okay, so if you simplify this whole part, it will be, you can cancel this, the decimal you can change, cancel, and if you see, this would be total, after finding out log, it will be 0.5228 is equal to, and this value will be 3133.63 into this T2, I'll take up T2 minus, this will go up, LCM we take 283.15, that is T2 minus T1 upon T1 T2, that is 283.15 into T2. Okay, now if you further simplify this, this I'll take on the either side, it will be 0.5228 divided by 3133.63 is equal to T2 minus 283.15 divided by 283.15 T2. Okay, so now what we will do, we will multiply this all things and simplify. What you will get here, this whole part, it will be, this whole thing I will take on the either side, means what, 0.5228 into 283.15 T2 divided by 3133.63 is equal to T2 minus 283.15. Okay, like this. So if you simplify this part, okay, you will get 0.0472 T2 is equal to T2 minus 283.15. Okay, if you simplify this further, this LCM all if you take and simplify, what you will get, T2 will be equal to 283.15 divided by 0.9528. Okay, you can do this calculation. Therefore, T2 is equal to 297.17 Kelvin. Understood? This is what we got. Now, if your T1 was given in degree Celsius, so T2 you can convert it. That is, T2 is equal to 297.17 minus 273.15, so which will be equal to 24.02 degree Celsius. Okay, so this is the answer. Okay, now the next question. Okay, next question is 4.29, what we are going to discuss. Now the time required for 10% completion of the first order reaction at this temperature is equal to the time that required for 25% completion at this temperature. If the value of A is, that is Arrhenius factor or frequency, what we say, is given there, calculate the K at this much Kelvin, and EA also you have to calculate. Now this is a lengthy sum, important sum. Chances are there for to be asked for 4 marks, what we say. Okay, so this one is lengthy but very easy it is. Okay, so we'll do this one now next. Now in question 4.29, certain things are given, what you can see here, just a minute, it is given at 298 Kelvin, we can say that let initial concentration will be R0 only, we will take, R0 will be R0, this is initial concentration is R0, right, but at 298 we saw that 10% completion, so RT is equal to what, 100 minus 10% of, sorry this whole I will take, 100 minus 10% of R0, so which is equal to 90% of R0, right, so which is equal to 90 by 100, so this will get cancelled, off means multiply by R0, so RT at this given temperature will be equal to 0.9 R0. Understood? So this part. Now same way we can calculate at, what we say it is, at 308 Kelvin, initial concentration we will take it as R0, clear, and RT is equal to 25% completion, so it is 100 minus 25% of R0, so directly 75 by 100, now directly will write into R0, so which is equal to 0.75 R0, right, means at this temperature RT is 0.75, and at this temperature RT is this, what we say. Okay, now the next part, what is given, see. Okay, the next part when we say, that is, you can write down, thus T at 298 Kelvin, now as it is first order I'll directly change, where formula is K is equal to 2.303 by T. So instead of that K, I will write here, because that value was given. So K into log R0 by RT, I will write. So which is equal to 2.303 by K at, what we call it as, 298 Kelvin into log R0 by, at 298 we know it was 0.9 R0. Okay, so this will get cancelled, so what it will be, 2.303 by K at 298 Kelvin into log, log we can write 1 upon 0.9. Okay? Okay, you can simplify this, that is 2.303 by K at 298 Kelvin is log 0.9 means 9 by 10, so that is equal to 10 by 9. Okay, now this is T time at 298 Kelvin. Same way, similarly, T at 308 Kelvin is equal to 2.303 by K, K for 308 Kelvin. Okay, log, it was 0.75. So what we can write instead of this, we can change it. Now if it is, so it was 0.75, so we can say, that is, if you want, I'll write it, R0 upon 0.75 R0. Clear? This will get cancelled. So 1 upon 0.75, the 75 upon 100, so 100 will go up. That is 308 Kelvin is equal to 2.303 by K at 308 Kelvin log 100 by 75. Now 100 by 75, you can simplify this. Okay, so it will be 4 by 3. 25 4s are, okay, and 25 3s are. So we can write like this. Okay, so T 308 Kelvin is equal to 2.303 K at 308 Kelvin log 4 by 3. So these two things you can remember what we got here. Okay, so now if we compare these two at different temperature, that is S time for 298 Kelvin is equal to time for 308 Kelvin, right? So if you compare this and substitute these two values in this, what you will get, that is here it will be 2.303 by K for 298 Kelvin here log into log 10 by 9 is equal to 2.303 by K for 308 Kelvin log 4 by 3. Okay. Now this part what we say will get cancelled, and what is remaining, that is log 10 by 9 is equal to, this will get cancelled from both the side. Okay. Now log 10 by 9, if you find the value, it will be 0.0458. Divide by this K 298 Kelvin is equal to log 4 by 3 0.125 by K 308 Kelvin. Okay, so K 308 Kelvin, this I'll take here and this part will come here like this. Okay, so divide by K 298 Kelvin comparison, it will be 0.125 divided by 0.0458. Okay, and that is equal to 2.7292. Okay, so we got this value here. Okay, now the next part what we say, that is now we know the formula, that is log K2 by K1 is equal to EA upon 2.303 R into 1 upon T1 minus 1 upon T2. Okay, so now this one we got the answer for this log what we got here. This K2 by K1 is this part what we say, K2 by K1. Understood? So that we are going to substitute all values. Okay. So now if I substitute the value, it will be log 2.7292 for that what we have found out upon into EA upon 2.303 into 8.314 joule Kelvin inverse, mole inverse, not kilojoule, is not required here, into temperature. 1 upon T1 is 298 minus 1 upon T2 is 308. Okay, like this. So if you simplify this, the value of this will be 0.4360, and this I will take on the either side, into 2.303 into 8.314. Okay, understood? This one also you can multiply. This one I will take here, 298 into 308 is equal to EA, and this will go up, that is EA, that is 308 minus 298. Okay, like this. Okay, so if you simplify, therefore EA will be equal to, if you simplify this whole part, okay, EA will be equal to, means what you will do, you will subtract this and take this here to divide it, this whole thing, huh? This whole thing you can divide, otherwise I'll write down one step. 0.4360 into 2.303 into 8.314 into 298 into 308 divide by 308 minus 298. Okay, like this. And then if you simplify this, you will get EA is equal to 76.62 kilo joule mole inverse. Okay, now kilo means here you must have got 10 raised to 3. Huh? Okay, you can convert it if not. Okay, now kilojoule mole inverse, that is the value of EA we got. Okay, now the next part, what is given? Now A we have to find now. So again, according to Arrhenius equation, according to Arrhenius equation, we know log A is equal to log K plus EA by 2.303 RT. Clear? Now if log K is here, that negative part, but here we have changed this, you can see in your textbook here. Huh? So log, substituting this value of EA and all everything, so you will see that log A value is also given. First we'll write down all the values. Just see, EA is equal to, we got 76.62 kilojoule mole inverse. Okay. Then T value is 318 Kelvin. Okay, this was asked in the question. Huh? Calculate the K at 318 Kelvin and EA, like this it is. So EA, we K temperature is given. Then value of A is 4 into 10 raised to 10 second inverse. Huh? This is also given in your question. Okay, so now this all value will substitute here. So it will be log 4 into 10 raised to 10 is equal to log K plus this value EA is 76.62 divided by 2.303 into 8.314 into 10 raised to minus 4, because our answer was kilojoule here for EA. Huh? So that's how I've taken here 10 raised to minus 3, huh? Not 4. Okay, into T, what we say is 318. Okay, so if you simplify this, this would be 10.6021. okay, this value of log is equal to this. If you don't know, you can do like this: log 4 plus 10 log 10 to the base 10. This power will get suppressed, and for this plus, so log 4 you have to find, and plus 10 you do, it will be 10.6021. Okay, log 4 is 60210 point. Okay, then log K plus this whole thing, if you simplify, it will be 12.5838. Okay, therefore log K is equal to 10.6021, this whole part I will take on the either side, minus 12.5838. Okay, which is equal to, this will be minus 1.9817. Clear? Now this is negative, so this we have to convert. Before that you cannot find anti-log. So what we will do, minus 1.0 minus 0.9817 plus 1 minus 1. So this you compare, and these two things you compare. So it will be 2.0183. Okay, now you can find the anti-log. Therefore K is equal to anti-log of 2.0183. As it is 2 bar, you can take to the power of 10, 10 raised to minus 2, and 0.018 and mean difference 3 in your log table. If you see, it will be 1043 after one digit decimal. So we got the value of K at the given temperature. Okay, this is little bit lengthy sum, but easy. See that you do it by yourself also, huh? After seeing from this. Okay, the next. Okay, now in this video we will not be doing this 4.30 because it will become very lengthy. So 4.30 we will be doing in the next, what you call, video 17. Okay, now So till here we'll stop. Next time we'll continue in video 17 the remaining numericals. Okay, thank you very much.